not saying I'm drunk, I suppose. If it looks like I'm laughing, I'm really just asking to leave. This alone, you're in time for the show. You're the one that I need, I'm the one that you loathe. You can watch me corrode like a beast in repose, cause I love all the poison away with the boys in the band.
Here in Yanbu, Saudi Arabia, aka Boringsville, we have many different people from different races. Yellow, black, brown, and white.
Hi guys, my name is Chris. I'm 14 years old, I'm from Philippines, and I'm big. I like to play basketball.
I woke up, it was 7. I waited till 11 just to figure out that no one would call. I think I've got a lot of friends.
Hey, what's up? Hello, my name is Nabil. I'm 13 years old. I'm from Pakistan, but I don't like declaring it. People say I don't look like it, but some people say I look like American or Canadian, but it might not look to you.
Delilah, what's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty.
Hey, my name is Nabeel, and I'm from India. I'm 13 years old, and I love to play soccer.
Hi, my name is Azri. I'm 14 years old.
I'm from Malaysia.
I've been in Yanbu for 2 years already, and I've enjoyed it a lot.
Our family is the biggest part of our life here in Yanbu. Without them, we could have gone to the wrong path. Sometimes they can expect too much from you, such as parental pressure on getting honor rolls. They sometimes say to look up to your older brother and sisters and tell us to be like them. Parents can limit us from certain things like staying up late to do homework, internet access, or going out. Despite all those negative points, our families can be sometimes the greatest happiness of our life. My family and I have been to so many places around the world, and I've enjoyed it a lot.
In Yanbu, there are language problems, as expects in Saudi. We need to know some Arabic to communicate with the shopkeepers. When you get an SMS on your cell phones from the service provider, it can be in Arabic. Now, this can be frustrating for you. The police officers also speak Arabic. When there is an accident, it's hard to communicate and the officers don't know who stole the food. So they end up believing the Arabic speakers. Even though, if you can speak Arabic and you're trying to fight against a Saudi, there's sometimes no hope to win.
There is religious tolerance at our school. People with different religion get along well. Some of us here come from Islam, Christianity, or Hinduism. Most of the Yanbuans here are Muslims. The Muslims here pray 5 times a day in the mosque or at home. This is the basic requirement of Islam. When it is the prayer time, all the shops are closed and everybody heads to the mosque. This shows how important prayer is. Religion over here affects us in so many ways, such as women in Saudis aren't allowed to drive, and this makes some female life harder. Women here are not allowed to even go out with just colorful clothing or normal dark clothes. Instead, they have to wear this black robe on top, which they call it abaya, because this is a part of the Islamic regulation. It is mentioned in the Quran that women have to wear clothing that cover their body, except the wrist and the face. Almost everything here in Yanbu between men and women is segregated. The restaurant, the water parks, the local schools, and many more.
There isn't a lot to do in Yanbu. For example, people can't go to the movies because there aren't any theaters. However, we have alternatives for entertainment. Some people have home theaters. Some of us go to the malls or the cafes. We also go over to each other's place. There are some parks in Yanbu to hang out. Others join gym to work out. Many of us play sports like soccer, basketball, volleyball, or badminton. We also take part in the school team and travel to other places. Some people play on the school band. They play guitar, drums, or sing. Others like to break dance or pop. We also have different trips either held by the school or some other communities from Yanbu. We sometimes hang out in the beach with family or friends. We camp out there and do many different activities. Most of us own some type of music player. We listen to music often. We listen to rock, heavy metal, soul rock, etc., rap, trance, blues, and jazz. We love Akon, Chris Brown, Lady Gaga, T-Pain, Florida, Neo, and Soulja Boy, Paramore, Evan Sevenfold, Eminem, the All-American Rejects, and many more. The student council arranges socials or dances at school sometimes. We also have talent shows.
In our school, some people wear their pants low even below their butts. Their shirts are very loose. Some people think this is cool. Others do it because they feel more comfortable. On the other hand, others like to wear tights. The type of shoes people wear here are basically Converse, Vans, Nike, or Adidas. One thing about Yanbu or the whole Saudi Arabia is that the oil is cheap, meaning that you can drive as far as you want without financial concerns. Though, if you are traveling from Yanbu to somewhere far, you'd probably want to use the toilet before you go because there aren't any public toilets during the journey, as you know that Saudi Arabia is full of desert.
In Yanbu, school is important to all of us. This is the place where we make friends, learn new things, and get smarter. We all try to achieve good grades. This can help us down the road. Our parents will also be happy with us. And the society getting a B or a C is not good enough. An honor roll or a high honor roll will put a happy face on our parents and teachers. Every parent envisions their kids to pass with an A. We all respect our teachers. When they are talking, we are quiet. In Islam, after your parents, your teachers deserve the most respect. Though sometimes teacher can get really boring, we then show disrespect by doing such stuff that can get them kind of mad and sometimes makes them happy. Some of us here want to become doctors, engineers, or businessmen. Others want to play sports like soccer or basketball for professional.
Some here still dreams of becoming their childhood superhero.
When I grow up, I want to be a chef and at the same time a professional golf player. In order to do so, I need to strive to achieve what I want. Though my dad wants me to be an engineer because only few people today are engineers.
I hope to become a professional soccer player when I grow up. I want to be in some Europe club. I know I will have to work hard to achieve my goals.
I dream dream of becoming a chemist one day. My interest is in chemistry and computer technology, so at the same time I hope to learn more about IT. I will try as best as I could to achieve what I want.
Yeah,
we're going in.
Okay.
It's going in.